The now established program has run smoothly over the last few weeks with plenty on offer. The team running activities aim to provide variety for different age groups on a daily basis, catering for children of different abilities.
One of my jobs is to, on a weekly basis, see what facilities we have, where we can be placed. This year we've been based in the Muga, but for example last week with the Electronic Music Festival, we did have to move, come inside. So that all takes time, sending letters home to parents, informing parents. So it has been a little bit of an issue, but we have been able to resolve it. So.
And from a sporting perspective, obviously stimulating the children as much as possible, how important is it to vary the programme and make sure, you know, that they actually sample as many sports as possible?
Yeah, so our programme throughout the 6 weeks, we do ensure that we cover every single sport. Our leaders are trained to be able to do that. We also have within the programme associations that do carry out their own sessions throughout. So the main idea is that in September, when September comes, children are take up sport and actually enjoy the actual sports that they're doing.
The Stay and Play programme, which caters for children with special needs, has seen a bigger intake this year.
We work on a one-to-one basis and we've got extra leaders this year employed, so it's really, really good. We've got loads of staff, really amazing staff, so that's how we've worked this year.
And with regards to the programme, obviously you're focusing on the children's needs. You work closely with St Martin's?
Yeah, we do an induction before we start, and one of the days we go to St Martin's and all the teachers brief us on all the children, and that's really, really helpful.
What type of activities are the children involved with on a day-to-day basis?
On a day-to-day basis, we do a lot of sports, we do a lot of arts and crafts, we do yoga, we do story time, we do a lot of water play, and we go swimming to the GSLA pool, and on a Wednesday we go off-site.
Plenty of work has gone into the summer extravaganza event, an interactive maze based on a particular storyline.
With an under-the-sea theme, it's really easy to let the imagination run wild. Through the tunnel, there are plenty of activities, all aimed at stimulating the children, ultimately focusing on fun. Off you go!
Well, normally we look for the themes that are like in trend. So for example, Minions was a big craze. Last year we had Pokemon. Pokemon Go was really in the mix. And this year, Finding Dory was a new film that had come out, and we thought it would be a really good theme to get the children involved. We literally, every day after we do our evaluations of work, we implement loads of ideas and what would go into the Finding Dory maze. So literally, since the second week, we've been planning this, and we stay loads of hours afterwards to set up everything and make sure everything's perfect.
This year, because we've got so many children that stay and play, we wanted to include them as much as possible into the maze. We've got a lot of sensory features at each station. We've focused on tactile, so we've got materials such as sensory foam, we've got a jelly bath, we've got pasta, and there's a lot of visual going on, a lot of audio, so the children are having their best experience, as you can see.
We had to come up with a storyline, so throughout, for example, in this one, they're collecting shells and they're going through the actual film of Finding Dory. So each station has their own part within the story. But yeah, it's been a two, three week process where we've come up with a storyline, setting our leaders' different characters, deciding what type of activities we could do linked to the actual film. So it has been, it's been a roller coaster ride, but at the end we do get results. Children love it, so that's what it's all about.
For those who may have missed this opportunity, the summer sports programme continues for one more week and concludes with fun water activities next Friday.